just ask Dan a different question. Dan, obviously you're doing a great job of hyping this fight with Marcus, but at any point you've gone too far? Somebody was at UFC 93. Marcus was genuine. His emotion at fighting in Ireland seemed very genuine, and yet you've been kind of dumping on him for that. Do you think there's a fine line between hyping it and that fight and going a little far? Do you think that you've overstepped the boundaries in this one?
I don't know, really. I mean, it's a good question. To be honest, you know, I looked at this fight. Originally, the fight was put to me from the fans. You know, the fans are the ones that wanted to see the fight. So, you know, I thought it was my responsibility to try and get this fight on. And realistically, for Marcus, it's not a good fight for his career. I mean, you know, to be fair, he's way ahead of me. You know, he should be really looking towards the title shot, you know, looking towards getting a couple more wins towards that. So, you know, to fight a guy who's just come into UFC and had two fights, I really didn't think he'd be taking the fight. So I did a few things to try and make sure that paper was signed. I knew that Poking Funny, I don't care whether he walks out with a kill or whatever, but, you know, I knew that poking a bit of fun at him would get a reaction out of him, which is exactly what happened. And then from then, you know, it started to get kind of silly. You know, he came on to, you know, a couple of different radio stations and TV shows in the UK, and he was doing all the trash talking and some of the stuff he was, you know, calling him a coward and things like that. I mean, how somebody's a coward when they're already trying to fight you, I don't know how that works, but... So I don't really know. I mean, you know, where do you draw the line? I started it to try and get the fight on, you know, for myself, for the fans, and Marcus got real upset about it, and what more can I say? I mean, the Photoshop thing was nothing to do with me, apart from the fact that I just posted the photograph up there, and the fans did what they wanted with it. I just think, you know, I think he's... any other person would have laughed it off, but I don't know, Marcus seems to be a bit too sensitive.
Marcus, do you think he crossed the line?
Oh, definitely crossed the line. And the only time that I said he was a coward, the only time I said he was a coward was when it was him that went on there and he put those pictures on, and then when he typed on there and said, "You guys go put these pictures up other places." He didn't take the pictures and put them up. He asked people to put them up. That's when I made that statement. I've always said, you know, that I respect Dan Hardy's fighting ability, that I've always said I'm not going to belittle his ability to fight because he can fight, but I'm not going to respect him as a person because he's not giving me any respect as a person. That was my statement.
Thank you.
Can I reply to that? Can I just say something to that? Anybody?
Sure. All right, go ahead.
That whole thing, basically, you know, he came on the internet, he came on the TV in the UK, and he said that I'd missed three interviews like this, you know, conference call interviews, and, you know, I didn't want to talk to him. Now, I genuinely did miss one of them, but that was due to the time difference and the confusion, and I apologise for that. So to go on there, you know, he's got bad teeth, and the whole, you know, people running around in Nottingham with Robin Hood types and all that nonsense, I mean, he's just making himself look stupid. And, you know, as far as respecting his fighting ability, I wouldn't want to fight him if I didn't think it was worth my while. So, you know, I do respect his fighting ability. Do I think he can beat me? No, I don't. But I do respect his fighting ability, and I do respect where he is in the division and what he's done for the sport and for his own career. But, you know, the whole... And saying that I wanted to get the Photoshop pictures posted everywhere is nonsense. That was emailed to me by a fan, and they said, "Have you seen this photograph? It's pretty funny." And all I did was post it up and put Photoshop anybody with a question mark. I didn't post them anywhere. I didn't ask for anywhere to post them anywhere. That was just the fans having fun, and if a 35-year-old man can't laugh that off...
That's not true. You're a liar.
I'm not a liar.
You put it on there. You're a liar.
Because
I saw the form, and then I saw after the pictures went on, I saw you go on there, I saw what you wrote. You wrote, "Hey, will you put him on, hey guys, go put him on Sherdog and MMA.TV. That was your friggin' picture that was by it, and you're the one that put it on there. You're not the one that asked them to go do that, because you did ask them to go do that.
No, I didn't. No, I genuinely did not.
Well, then somebody using your picture and using your name, Dan Hardy, on that UK forum, that the UK, the other UK fans sent email at me. That's how I found the forum. They emailed me and said, "You have to go to this forum and see what he's doing."
That's very possible. But what you're going to bear in mind is I didn't post that picture up for me and the UK fans to have a little laugh. I posted that up because you said I was insulting you in private. Now, why would I do that? What do you think I'm scared of you or something? Is that what you think, really?
No, I don't. Yeah, I've never. You wouldn't be a fighter if you were afraid of anybody that you were fighting. That's just not in our, that's not in our genetic makeup. I don't care if you fear me or you don't fear me.
So what's the thing in your blog about saying I won't say anything to your face, etc., etc.? You know, I'll look you in the eyes on June 12th at the weigh-in, and I'll tell you I'm not afraid of you. And on June 13th, I will show you I'm not afraid of you.
Yeah, we'll see.
How about that? Yeah, we'll see. Yeah, we'll see. I'm looking forward to that, and I just hope you're ready, because I'm ready as hell. That's all I can say.
Yeah, we'll see, buddy.
Thanks, Joe.
Our next question comes from Chris Hightower from MMA.net.
Yeah, I actually had a question that was similar to that, so I'll just follow up on that conversation. It's for both Dan and Marcus. The first part is, Dan, do you think that the emotional response you got from Marcus will help you in your fight? And then, Marcus, do you think that your emotional response will help you? And for both of you, who do you see facing in the future after a win?
Who do you want to go first?
Go ahead, Dan.
Whether it'll help in the fight or not, I don't really know. Marcus is a tough guy and he always comes ready to fight. So I'm expecting a tough Marcus Davis regardless of whether he likes me or not. I don't really think it'll factor into the fight too much. All I know is that he signed that piece of paper that said that he's going to fight me and it'll be there on June 13th. And that was all I was interested in.
You know what, I pretty much agree with what he just said. I hate to say it, but yeah, I mean, I don't think either one of us are gonna, I think that we both have so much experience, so many fights. I don't know, this is over my 100th and something as far as boxing and K-1, kickboxing and MMA. So, I mean, I won't take it into the ring that night and act like a wild man, and I know he won't either, so we'll just, we'll go out there, we'll perform the best that we can perform, and then that'll be it. And I mean, and honestly, I don't know, I have nobody in sights for me, like, who I'm looking to fight. Really, I just got to take it one fight at a time, and this is going to be a really tough, difficult fight, so this is the only one that I can concentrate on. I can't think about what